that has a melting degree temperature of over 4,000 degrees Fahrenheit had melted, and so on. So the idea that fire alone could have caused these, fires couldn't have gotten over 1,800 degrees, is just scientifically absurd. It's just impossible. So that's the first half of my book, was showing how they had simply denied a lot of physical evidence, the evidence of molten steel that many, many people testified to, and John Groth, who was one of the lead authors for the NIST report, and when he was asked about this in public, he said, oh, I know of nobody, no credible eyewitness who has said that there was molten steel. In the second part of my book, I deal with NIST's own theory as how fire would have brought the buildings down, and showed that in each case they simply had to tell enormous lies. In terms of scientific fraud, this is called falsification and fabrication of evidence. For example, they claim that the building fell. This gets a little technical, but the main point is simple. They said these the girders were not connected to the floor slabs with shear studs, and therefore they were easily moved, and that started a process that led to global collapse. But if you look back in the 2004 interim report on World Trade Center 7 that NIST itself had put out, they said the steel beams and the girders were connected to the floor slabs with shear studs. They copied that almost verbatim in their later report and just omitted the word "and girders," and then said that the steel beams were connected but the girders weren't. So here you have an obvious fabrication, falsification of data. Another example, their theory rests on huge fires on floors 11, 12, and 13, huge fires that they allege. They give you graphics that show you how these fires were progressing on the various floors. At 5 o'clock on floor 12, the graphic shows an enormous raging fire. And, of course, that would have been 21 minutes before the building came down. So the idea was this fire was getting hotter and hotter and hotter, and finally the building simply couldn't resist. But if you look back at that same 2004 interim report, here's what you read. There were some fires on floors, blah, blah, blah. The fires on floor 12 were completely burned out by 4:45. I mean, this is you would think I'm making this up, but it's just unbelievable that they could just tell outright lies like this. But they knew they could tell them, and the press wouldn't give them away. And thus far, that has been the case, so I'm very grateful to you for giving us a chance to let at least some of the American people know that this NIST report is a total fabrication. It should be an embarrassment. The people in the movement are making efforts to bring this to the attention of people who will deal with NIST in the proper way and expose this book as an egregious example, maybe the most egregious example yet, of scientific fraud committed by a government agency.
Okay, good. Now, ready to go to some of the other important questions.
Good.
And a lot of these questions are from the media, and we need to address them as objectively as possible. One of the challenges that you have had is that we know that the people who committed the crime were members of Al-Qaeda and other terrorist groups out of Saudi Arabia principally, and that our government and our military would never engage in such an act and has never engaged in such an act to make to do anything of this nature on American soil. Your response, please.
Okay, let me take the second part first. Jesse Ventura was just on The View yesterday, and the women of The View just were outraged by the idea that he would think that our own government could have done something like this. And Barbara Walters said, if our own government, even, you know, Bush and Cheney, killing 3,000 of our own citizens, now that's an exaggeration, of course, but leave that aside. I just can't believe it. I just can't believe it. Well, one problem is here, she's letting her a priori ideas trump physical evidence, because Jesse was saying, look, this building came down in under 7 seconds, almost free fall. That can't happen without explosives. And they were saying, I just can't believe, just can't believe. So that's one point. Secondly, the question, what our government would do, what did our government do a few days after 9/11, after the Boston Globe had reported on September 13th that the air was filled with asbestos? It was dangerous. The EPA was going to put out a warning and say the air is unsafe to breathe. The Bush White House ordered them to change their report, take out all the warnings and say, and then we have the infamous words, the air is safe to breathe.
Christy Whitman, the head of the FDA, the EPA at the time.
That's right. She caved and obeyed the White House's orders.
And later stated that she was under pressure to modify the situation.
Yeah, and as I reported in The Mysterious Collapse of World Trade Center 7 and some of my other books, this has been documented now. People within the EPA have stated that they were ordered by the White House to make this false statement, and that they knew it was false at the time. And as a result, now we have thousands, many thousands of the first responders, the firefighters and the people in the cleanup crew, who have terrible illnesses. Many of them will be ill the rest of their lives. Some of them have died already. Some people predict that more people are going to die from the cleanup and rescue effort than died on 9/11 itself. So to say that the Bush-Cheney administration would not deliberately do anything to kill American citizens is falsified right there. Secondly, we know that we now know it was all a lie as to why we went to Iraq. The mainstream press still has not driven home this point that the head of British intelligence reported to Tony Blair in 2002 that the Bush administration was determined to go to war. The pretext was going to be weapons of mass destruction. When the question was asked, well, how do they know they're going to find weapons of mass destruction? The answer was the intelligence and the facts are going to be fixed around the policy. So this was not bad information. This was falsification. This was deliberate lie. And now how many Americans have died in Iraq? So this claim that we would not do such a thing. Also, if we go back in history, we've got the Operation Northwoods that was going to, after Cuba had gotten taken back by the Cubans, we thought, well, no, that's our country. We're going to take it back. The Pentagon came to President Kennedy with a proposal called Operation Northwoods, and the title on the cover said, Pretext for an Invasion of Cuba. And some of the pretexts would have involved killing American citizens. For example, they said, well, we could have a kind of Remember the Maine kind of incident, which, of course, we used to take Cuba in the first place. Said we could blow up an American ship and blame the Cubans. Another plan was to kill American citizens on the streets of Miami and Washington and blame the Cubans and so on. And there was a proposal to shoot down a plane, blame the Cubans. So the idea that our government would not kill its own citizens in order to have a pretext for military action is simply historically false.
We also falsified the Gulf of Tonkin incident.
That's right.
That never happened.
only about 1,000, I forget the exact figure, Americans had died in Vietnam, maybe not even that many, but